All right, so I was looking at the math. If I spend 1 minute on every character, if I spend 30 seconds on every character, there's still 80 characters as of next week in this game. So to trim it down, we're going to skip over the bad and we're going to skip over the mid. Unless there's something like glaring that I need to point out, we're just going to bypass them altogether and just go into the other stuff. So with that said, let's get started. First thing is that I wanted to make sure that I used centers first because they can sway the flow of the game the most. Actually, let's point out a couple things while we're here. So first thing is Marcus. He's in bad. Some people wonder why isn't he mid. The character does absolutely nothing. He has one trick. And the thing with the trick is he can trip you after rebounds. Shout out to Walker here, who's cooking up. He can trip you after rebounds to steal the ball. It doesn't work on putbacks. It doesn't work on red pass. It's essentially Jean's burst, but way worse. So yeah, he's trash. A lot of the other characters you might see here and wonder why they're in bad. As the game goes on, you just understand. So Kong is mid. He's supposed to be really strong, but we're supposed to be in a era of the game where people are dunking. No one needs to dunk now. There's T-Mac and AI. Like, none of that matters. So other than that, he has a nice putback, and he's pretty decent on rebounds and decent on box out. He's just decent on everything else. He's not great at anything. Jean is a horse. She's a complete horse, but that's all she can do. So here, I'll show you an example. This is Toru. He is the best rebounder in the game, and she just stole the rebound from him. That's invaluable. Another thing is, I'm sure you've seen by now, she can knock you down with the box out. And one other thing is that if you hold the box out long enough, she gets a stat buff. So if you look closely, this was not supposed to be my rebound at all. Like, I didn't jump nearly high enough to take that. But yeah, she does have some pluses. So let me see if there's anyone else. Mason has good box out. He has a quick jumper, but it's a dunk. Barbara is a menace. Okay, I'll show you some Barbara real quick. By the way, I'm going in order. Centers, power forwards, small forwards, shooting guards, etc. Barbara does one thing. She does one thing over and over again, and people have trouble blocking it. She does a straight dunk, nothing fancy. She has a couple different timings she can mix in. But yeah, it's essentially a one-trick pony, and it cooks, unless you have someone like Kong. So speaking of dunk block timing, let's get these out of the way. Worst characters in the game. If you have a Tiger or Big Buddy, I don't know what to tell you. Bridget and Lily suck, but at least she's the starter character. And Cooper, if you take the worst parts of Bang, and the worst parts of Yon, and the worst parts of, like, you just take all the bad SGs, and you combine them together and take away all the positive aspects, you get Cooper. So he's mega trash. Let's go ahead and keep going. Lexi, she's a pillar. PF, nothing much to say. Fakuda's, he's okay. He's a definition of mid. Goku is actually pretty nice, but he's still is in mid category. There's nothing you can do about it. So here, take a look at Dragon's clip. He actually got blocked here, but the monster dunk feature just chooses not to. Yeah, it's pretty crazy. In addition to that, you can shoot some contested threes. He's pretty nice. Weird thing here is the blue here PF is Kagamichi or Kagami, but the red hair PF is Almini? I don't know. Not gonna ask. Anyways, Kagamichi's, he's pretty mid too. So the thing he has is he has, this spin. So he can spin a couple times. Essentially, the issue is you have to guess how many times he's gonna spin before he dunks. One good thing that he does have, which is like the one good thing that he does have, is that he can get to the paint all the way from the three. So here, I'll show you that real quick. Only on a pass though. So here from the three, spin, 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 dunk. But yeah, other than that, he's a one-trick pony. Like, he doesn't have anti-collision. He doesn't have anything good for him. The player is really good. I'd say he's at the top of the mid list. He sucks really bad at NA, but let me show you. One thing that can happen with the player is every time you cross someone, you get a dribble speed boost. So if you get 5 speeds and you have the right runes or the right builds, it gets pretty nutty. So like at this point in time, yeah, it's pretty wild. Vivian is pretty decent, but people suck at building characters or suck playing them. Once you drop someone, her drive speed goes crazy. So here, take a look at this. This is me just 1v1 in homie, but if you see the drive speed after, it's bananas. And my runes aren't maxed. And that's at half court, by the way. Heejong, not much to say with her. Rose, she's good, but she's just good. So I'll give you a quick cover of that. I'm still trying to rush because we're already at 7 minutes. She has a catch and double drive. So this catch and double drive gets you to the basket. She can float out of it right here. And she can bounce pass out of it. So that's the best thing. So yeah, that's her. Unfortunately, it's a mid kit. Claire is the best character at loose balls. So here, I can actually show you this. This is what Claire looks like during a loose ball situation. That looks like hacking. And then she has a rolling dive. So she has some cool things, but she's still mid. Alright, so let's get into the really good stuff. So starting from centers. Shaq is awesome. Here's what Shaq looks like. Shaq is actually so awesome that he got nerfed. So like I said, we're going to try to keep it to 30 seconds. Before he was nerfed, this is what he looked like. Blocking from over here, behind them. He was blocking unblockable shots. Midorima's shot, you can't block. He's blocking unblockables. And this is what he looks like after he's nerfed. So, character's good. He can still rebound. He can still score. He's a good pick. The thing is, he has... he doesn't have high arc shots, so shots that will go over Natsuki's wall will not go through Shaq's block. So let's do him at the same time. Nat is also pretty good. Right now, he's very dominant because NA doesn't have center talents, but that wall, it's just you can reactively block from very far away unless it's a high arc shot and goes over. He also has this tap rebound, which can be really useful if paired with a good loose ball character like Claire or Kim. Toru would go in S or SS. Actually, I'm going to give him his own. Alright, here we go. So the thing with Toru is, if there's a Toru on the other team, just make sure there's no rebounds or you lose. Like, that's it. Like, if there's rebounds, you don't get them. He doesn't jump like this in A because talents are missing and shoes are missing. But yeah, take a look at this. Like, he moves like a PG during a loose ball situation. But he's rebounding and dunking. Another thing is, I showed you Jean was a horse. And she was able to get the rebounds over Toru because her burst auto-activated. This is what it looks like when her burst isn't auto-activated. Keep in mind, she's a horse and she's getting dominated. So, yeah, he's, don't do it. Okay, Sam Lung. If you remember Sam Lung from Dunk Nation. Woo! Yeah, he was the shit. But here, let's go and take a look at Sam Lung real quick. He has a really interesting kit. Alright, so he has a cool putback. He has a block that knocks the ball in the air for rebound situation. I don't know why. Who wants that? decrease rebound situations. But it works. He has a rebound pass. It's not like Rucho where he cocks it behind his head and throws it really slow. He just grabs it in and goes. Here goes the blocker yet. And he also has a block and grab. He does have a pretty decent dunk too. So if you need him to score, he can get a bucket or two. Murasaki Ibarra is one of my favorite GOM characters. Alright, so with him, let's see if we can get this moving a little quicker. With Murasaki Ibarra, he has a skill where if he's screening and you pass it to him, he'll just keep the pass moving. He'll non-stop pass it. He has a Vice Claw rebound. He has a little dunk pass kick. He also has some blocking and, like I said, good rebounding. He's just a good character overall. He would be S tier, but the game just got too crazy. Same with Tepe. Tepe is—he's the only person on the court you have to worry about doing this as a center. Keep in mind that is a three. That's not a burst. That's just a normal shot. Additionally, he can put back. He can break pass. He can do the same thing he just did, but going towards the paint and pass or dunk out of it. And for three-point shooting, he is number one in the game, higher than everyone else. So, yeah, he's kind of crazy. So, Draken should go into S. But, yeah, he changes how you play the game, too. So, let's go take a look at Draken real quick. If you're playing against Draken, you'll spend a lot of time on the ground not knowing how you got there. Like this. He has a move where he drives through you and you fall sometimes. This is a center moving like this, dunking from there. He can screen you to the ground too. So actually, You just hang out on the ground when you're playing against Draken. Usually when I'm on defense, like this example, I didn't even realize he was coming to screen me. Gene knew he was there, couldn't do anything about it. He goes over here. Like, he's ridiculous. So yeah, he changes the way you have to play the game. Boa is solid A tier. She has rep height. She has a skill where if she's sprinting, she sprints faster than usual, and she can't be screened during the sprint. She has a layup that gets a lot of buckets. This little layup doesn't have much of a startup animation. It cooks. She has a burst that slows down people's movement speed. So she bursted. Look how slow everyone's moving on defense. Still got the block. Look how slow the drive is. Look at Clara's burst spin. Like, it looks like it's actually slow motion. She's good. So now we're into PFs. Let's get crazy. Almany, that's going to be our first S character. So you'll see Kais using some of his moves and you're like, dang, why aren't you S tier? It's because when he drives forward or backwards. So he can break your ankles and all this stuff. But the point is, if he's driving forward, you have to go under the rim to paint camp his layup. And if he goes backward instead, he's still going to fade even further. So he puts you in like no man's land all the time. He's still a PF, he can block. And he has a really good double clutch layup. So yeah, his kit is, before some other characters I don't want to spoil yet, he was the best one-on-one character, period. So he's like T-Mac without as much cheese. This is our first SS tier character. Chihiro is bananas. So this is a defensive character, a defensive passer. He's not a scorer. He just happens to get buckets. So, all right, let's take a look. I'm not a useless player on the court. I'm gonna be frank, like, I carry my own weight. In this game, I ended up with all zeros across the board, and I did nothing wrong because he cooked all game on offense, just needed me in the corner, and then I was playing defense, and he would just come block from nowhere. Like, yeah, he's him. In addition to that, like, here goes an example. Yeah, he's a blocking PF. Blocking is his primary. Scoring is a mistake. He also has a double clutch shot, so if you clamp him, back. I love you. You probably didn't clap him anyways. Tifa is goated. One of my favorite characters as well. She teeters between A and S tier. I'll give her F's. Let me go ahead and show you what she's working with. She can cook. Yeah, she can cook. She gets around the court. She has defense. And she's a rebounding PF, not a scorer. So just like Chihiro's like a defending PF and he just gets buckets, she's a rebounding PF and she gets buckets too. Let me see where we're at. So we're almost at 20 minutes. Let's see if we can rush this out because we got a bunch left. LeBron is A. He's really good, but he's boring as fuck. Let me show you. So LeBron has a couple cool things with him. The best way to play him is pillar. So actually, I'll show you this. He has this block burst range. He has this spin. The second spin that I did, the quick spin, you cannot be faced up. So if someone is in your way, you will go through them, which makes him great at pillar because if they are playing sides like that, he just went through the Murasaki bar. He got blocked here. He got blocked once whole game. He went through the Murasaki bar. So if they don't play sides, he'll just fade. And if they do can't paint, then he'll fade again. And if they come past the screen, he'll go in using the spin and then dunk. He's really good. Really boring. Like, really, really boring. But he's good. He gets a bucket. Actually, let me show you before I close that. Bro scored 29 on two defensive bigs. And I did nothing all game besides, like, pass and play defense. So, yeah. Here we go. Yor is also pretty cracked. So here's the crazy thing with her. She gets around the court, like, she moves. She has a situation where she gets more shot speed as the game goes, up to 5 stacks. She also gets this thing where she, she just shot that over Natsuki's wall. Get wrecked. She has another thing where she can steal like a PG. She has another feature where if she gets cooked and her ankles get taken, she gets up faster. And if she, she's harder to go down as well. So let's go ahead and add one more row. And this is going to be the what the fuck, bro. Bro. So that goes to one character. There's only one character. This guy is bananas. Let's see if we can rush through these real quick. So, this isn't a burst. This isn't like a crazy something. That is him pressing block. Just block button. And this isn't a glitch. It looks glitchy. That's just how he plays. He dunks from the three board. And he has a dunk pass. Shot pass. His hook is ignores interference once every 40 seconds. Since he has a shot pass that cycles, he can shoot threes. His three-point stat is 10. Not like plus 10, but his three-point stat is 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, 10. And he can go 3 from 3 from the game, just chucking threes. If you'll notice, that's the same game. I just shot past it 4 times, and then I shot a 3, and it worked. T-Mac, I would give him, I really want to put him in A because he gets buckets, but they're 2 points, and you already saw what this guy does. But I'll give him S just because only thing that T-Mac has is, so one thing that people don't pay attention to is he has crazy off-ball speed. So if you wanted to try to run dash with T-Mac as a joke, you could. Off-ball, he just gets a lot of speed. He has a slight drive start speed, strike dribble speed. That ball fake is what carries him. Since he can go through you, and it crumbles you even if you're stationary, it's pretty OP. He also hits threes at a pretty high clip. He has one guaranteed three-pointer. He's good. He's impressive right now, but in the end game, he gets a lot worse. There's characters who hard counter him. You'll see that soon. Okay, Edgy. This character is actually our second SS tier character. So, here's what he does. He blocks like a PF, He can steal like a PG. He has a dash up steal, dash up block. He has increased shot speed in that situation. And he has a forward drive, a bounce off drive, and a really, really good, double clutch layup. And he has a drive dunk. So in short, he's the best overall defender, and he gets the bucket every time. So if you saw, this is the best scorer. This guy is the best scorer. I mean, not that person, best character. And he's just been waiting there to hold possession, ready to lock his shit up. So yeah, crazy character. All right, let's see if we can get faster here. KD is really good. He's like T-Mac, but okay. I have to show you this. Let me show you what KD is about. Yeah, you go ahead and take a moment and take this in. I feel the Shaq. I feel what the Shaq is going through. Worst part is he scored. So KD. KD has a really fast drive speed. He has a pull-up jumper. He doesn't have like the anti-collision per se that T-Mac has. He has a crazy passive where if he shoots mids, every mid he makes or misses gives him plus 10% field goal. So if you shoot 10 mids, make them or miss, you're going to get your guaranteed three. So what they usually do is they shoot like four or five mids and then they chuck a three and it usually goes in. He has increased shot speed. He has one move right here. So this move, if he does this dunk or fade, he will go through you. So this has no collision. So it's not as based as the T-Mac one, but it's still pretty good. Next one, we have Kais. So he should be A tier or S tier. It depends on what version you get. I'm going to leave him at A tier because I don't know what... I don't want to base it off of a nerf or non-nerf. But here, let me give you an example. So this Kais is complete trash. As you see, he took a contested layup on two people. No IQ. However, he dropped 15 this game because he just did Murasaki Barra's dunk as a burst. His burst is still full. Next possession. I give him the ball. He does Kuroko shot from three as a small forward instead of two. I don't know why. He still has full burst. He does Shintaro's charge shot. Still has full burst. He went on the rest of the game and scored 15 by just pressing his burst skill. That's what he is like after the buff. The one in NA right now is pretty trash. The one in SEA or PH is pretty trash. We got Kogure. He's good. He's good and he's boring. Let me go ahead and see if we can. He has like an L cut drive. You can't catch him. Can't really stop him. He's just going to get 2 points and do that floater from wherever. And he's a passing SF. So he's really good, but he's like watching paint dry. Like he's like Bron. Mikey is a demon. So let me show you Mikey. Mikey has one key feature that people overlook. During his burst, he starts off with 2500 energy. During his burst, his flex stat matches his jump stat for blocking and his three-point stat. So he presses burst, then he's walking around with 200 jump and with 200 three-point. He can dive as you just saw. He can start shooting contested threes. He can cook you up like this. We'll get to that part too. He becomes a demon three times a game. Also, it can be more if he has a Kasamatsu on his team because he can get energy from here. He also has a bounce off skill. So for the first play, possession of every play, every time you stop him, he'll bounce off. And then this dunk, I don't know if it's unblockable, but it will knock anyone away. So maybe Shaq can get it or something, but yeah, essentially I'm just gonna call it unblockable. Thomas is, he's mid, I'm sorry. Rukawa is the best, oh sure. You know, I'll show you Thomas just to keep things going. I'll see if we can try to rush this through too. Let me see, what's our time? Oh geez, all right, so let's try to rush this through. Thomas, he's like, some other good characters, just without the focus. So this is Thomas. Thomas is like Himuro, but without all the unstoppable sauce. So if you notice in this game, the top tier characters have the best things from all characters, kind of the opposite of what these guys do. So that's Thomas. Rukawa is the best character in the game that doesn't have a bailout button. So like T-Mac has a button where you just press, you know, ball fake and you get open. He has a double back dribble and a double forward dribble. So essentially the dribbles that Edgy has, he has those. And the back dribble that Chihiro or Miyazumi has, he has those. So this character can cook up if you have skills, but he's not a bailout character. So yeah, he's probably my favorite character overall in the game, not lore wise or anything. Sendo is my favorite character lore wise. He's essentially a small forward who's a PG. So when he starts his dribble, you can't face him up or collision him. You have to catch him at the end of the dribble like that or before he dribbles. Otherwise he can go in, he can hit paint, and he can cook because he has a shot pass. Really good character. I don't know what to tell you. Let's see where they go. Forrest is also mid. Forrest is mid, but I'll show you him because he's really interesting. So let me show you real quick. Forrest has a situation where he makes a hotspot from some place where he shoots and he doesn't get blocked. Those hotspots don't give him reduced accuracy. So if he wants to, he can go shoot half courts all game. Let me show you what a hotspot looks like. That. So now the thing with these hotspots is he also wants to pump fake and get you to jump and shoot, because then he gets a smaller interference zone, whatever. He's a weird character. He's pretty nifty, but he's not great. Yeah, Haruka, I want to give her S, but I have to give her A tier. Reason being is she doesn't have a shot pass. The thing that makes her really good is she covers up a lot of room really fast. But also the problem with that is that here, I'll show you. So she gets crazy space. She covers the whole court really, really fast. But because she covers the court really fast, that means you can pretty much zone her and there's nowhere for her to go from there. So I don't know what to tell you. She's whatever. Eileen is mid. She's the first character with a shot pass. She has another little thing that makes her interruption zone bigger in order to cook you. So it's kind of crazy. I'll show you. When she dribbles, the zone gets bigger. So if you're trying to avoid getting your ankles breaking by staying out of the zone, zone gets bigger. She has a shot pass. She has a couple things. She's good, but she's not great. Iverson is S. Let me show you why. First thing is, he has this dribble. If he breaks your ankles, you're not there. It's wide open. Other thing is that he can mix up the dribbles. He's just very efficient. He can score in a very small place, but the main reason why he's so ridiculously high is because this boy got defense. He has a quick steal. He has a crazy intercept that's better than half the PGs. Himuro is the number three SS tier character. So he is the best scorer in the game. All right, let me show you this real quick. So with him, this is a bad Himura with no drive speed too. He will cook a 3-on-1. Just guard up. Also, every time he passes, scores, or assists, he gets +2 3-point. For the whole entire team. So yeah, in this case, everyone else gets +24 3-point. Crazy character. Kenny is pretty good. I would give him A, but he doesn't make the cut. He's really good for dash. Let's see where this goes. Midorima is wild. So if he's buffed, he goes to SS tier. If he's in his current state or whatever state, depending on which version you're in, he's S. So let me show you what he does really quickly. That's so bananas. Before he's buffed, he's just like a normal character. He's a normal dash character. He shoots high arc shots, so they go over you pretty often. He does what he can. Let me show you what he looks like when he is buffed, though. So this is current buffed Midorima right there. And this is buff Midorima doing dash. So this is when he uses a dash skill. That's not a glitch. That's not fast. That's not 2x speed. That's just how he moves. So yeah, that character can be crazy. Additionally, he has one more thing I'll show you later. No, I'll show you now. Whatever. He has one more thing where if you pair him with two Kasamatsus, they can do something really cheesy where Kasamatsu... they just energy farm is what I'm going to call it. They energy farm each other. Then he shoots an unblockable shot that always goes in. And then he shoots an unblockable shot that always goes in. And then he shoots an unblockable shot that always goes in. And he does it for the rest of the game. So if you don't outscore him before maybe half, or get them in a situation where they can't catch up, you lose because they shoot threes that just go in for the rest of the game and you can't do anything about it. It's pretty nice. Boxhead is a solid score. I would give him S tier, but I have to give him A tier. He's just not strong enough. Let me go ahead and show you what he has. So first thing Boxhead has is a bounce off. So he can bounce off. He has a shot pass. He has a forward drive, forward spin drive, back drive. And because he has a shot pass, he can cycle and not miss any shots. This is what he looks like when he's max drive speed. So yeah, he moves. He's pretty crazy. He's a good character. Will is an S tier character. Let me show you what's up with Will. Will, when he passes to his teammates, he buffs the 3-point. But his shot pass counts as a cycle. So he can shoot all game and make all shots, unlike most PGs. Also, when he does this wave, he cannot be collided. So he just buffed the hell out of that edgy. This, he can't be collided, but he can drop you. And you can't steal from the ball when he's setting it up. So essentially, he's like immune to defense during this whole process. And then he can pass it to his teammates and buff him. To Cow, I would totally give him S, but he's just, I don't know. It wouldn't be fair to give him S, but let me show you. So to Cow, one thing, he has this layup. It looks so easy to block and so cheesy. It's not easy to block, and it's very cheesy. It has no startup animation. He just goes up with it. These guys aren't playing bad defense, by the way. He does this to everyone. And then on top of that, his passing is ridiculous. So I don't know the last time you've seen a PG pass half-court bounce passes, but Takao's your guy. He's really, really good. He's bananas. Let's see. Akashi is a steal bot. All he does is steal. His drive layup has too low range, but he gets two quick steals, which makes him arguably the best stealer in the game. This Emperor Eye doesn't work on bigs because they can bait it and block you. Takemichi falls into S, but he actually goes into changes how you play the game. So let me show you what he does. That's the character I play currently. If his hands are up, he cannot fall. He also gets twice the collision size. So remember I was telling you Chihiro is like the shit? Yeah, that's me just stopping a Chihiro with relative ease as long as I'm close enough to him. So here's what it looks like. If you're a dribbler and there's Takemichi around, you are not a dribbler. So figure it out. Also, his offense is pretty decent too. Let me show you. That time jump goes through you. You can't be collisioned. He has a manual dunk. He also has another thing where if he passes you the ball immediately, it's either 150 or 100 energy to the whole team. So let me take a look. I pass it to T-Mac. I have 954 energy. He dunks it. We all got that energy boost. So Takemichi's pretty crazy. He changed how you play the game. Ryota is really good. He can score. He can do some stuff. He has a pretty strong buff that people don't know. If you're losing, if you see, he gets shot speed. He gets a couple other things. If you want, I can translate it for you. His intercept is pretty bananas. This cost me this game because I didn't know he can intercept after the ball is going in that direction. And his loose balls are really strong too. Kind of like in this situation with speed is key. Let's see what else we got here. I'm trying to hurry. Oh man. Okay. We'll talk about this later. Kenji is S tier, so shoot, let me check the time. Oof, alright, we gotta wrap it up. Kenji's S tier, let me tell you about him. He has an anti-steal. So, step one, he has an anti-steal. By the way, that was a edgy stealing that, if you saw. He has anti-steal. He has a quick shot, double pump. He has double drive. He has shot pass, layup pass, double clutch shot, double clutch layup. And like I said, he has a quick jumper without needing to get a pass. Maki is my favorite PG. He blocks like a PF. He has moving quick jumper. that never gets old. He blocks moving quick jumper. He has a nice little drive layup. So let me show you real quick. Alright, here goes the drive layup. It's pretty effective too. And then, like I said, moving quick jumper, which is pretty good. It's not great, but it's all you need for offense. But the clamps are crazy. Kind of like this. Really fun. Alright, so we're almost done. Kasematsu is S tier. Actually, I would give him S tier. But it's like he has to go into the changes the way you play the game. So here's what he does. He can contest you 10 times. His passive goes up to 10 stacks. He gets more intercept. He gets more mid-range. He gets shot speed. Not shot speed. He gets energy recovery up to 10 times. So with those 10 stacks, he becomes a menace. He has flank screen. He has a dive roll. He can use a dive roll to steal or to just get loose balls. He's a menace to society. And here's how he changes how you play the game. Like I said, this type of tactic is bananas. So if a Kasematsu uses his burst, he gives everyone on the team energy. If another Kasematsu on the team gets energy from that burst, he can give the other Kasematsu energy. So essentially, if you have two Kasematsus, they can energy farm and give you unlimited energy, which is why this tactic works. And it's AIDS. So they nerfed King. I don't know why the Kasematsu do it, but yeah, he's whatever. Alright, and the last one we have is Hype Train. So Curry's coming out by the end of the week. I will let you know. I'll probably just put a video up. And that's it. Like, this video is long as hell, but that's 80 characters. Hope it helps. Let me know if you have any questions.